Hi there. In probability, it's important to know how the data or variables behave. And that is why we study the distribution that can be fit with a curve. The standard normal distribution is a specific case of the normal distribution that will help us calculate the probability of a score or compare scores from different normal distributions. The normal distribution, or Gaussian distribution, is a symmetrical curve that shows in the horizontal axis data of a variable that we are studying, and in the vertical axis representing the probability and function of the variable values. The area under the curve is always equal to 1 because the probability is also equal to 1 always. The maximum value of the probability is the most likely value to obtain, because it is the average value. The width of the curve is defined by the standard deviation of a data set. When the standard deviation is small, we will have a slimmer curve, and when the standard deviation is big, the width of the curve will increase. Then, the normal distribution plot is a function of x, being x the variable we are studying that depends on the standard deviation of x and the mean of x, that follows the next equation. The standard normal distribution, as its name said, is the standardization or conversion of the normal distribution. In this case, the mean will always be 0 and the standard deviation equal to 1. Therefore, for any study or experiment, we will use the same curve. But we will need to standardize our data. To do this, I am going to introduce the most important term. The standard score, or z-score, are measures of the x-axis that tell us the probability at certain point of the curve. And to obtain these z-scores, we will use the next formula. It is necessary to know the mean and the standard deviation of our set of data, and have a table of values with us. This table of values can be found online or in a book. The standard score table is easy to use, but at first can be a little tricky. First, you have to calculate the standard score. Let's suppose we have a x score equal to 23, a standard deviation of 7, and a mean of 26. Using the formula, we get a z score equal to minus 0.43. We go to our book or document, and we will have data for values less than 0 and greater than 0. In this case, our standard score is smaller than 0. In the left side, we have to look for the first decimal. For this example, 4. And then look for the second decimal. And the value between these numbers is our probability, equal to 0.3336, or 33.36%. If we see the representation with the graph of the standard normal distribution, we can find that the area under the curve, when the value z is minus 0.43, is equal to the value we obtained from the table. I think we are ready to solve an example. An automobile manufacturer introduces a new model that averages 27 miles per gallon in the city. A person who plans to purchase one of these new cars wrote the manufacturer for the details of the tests and found out that the standard deviation is 3 miles per gallon. Assume that in city mileage is approximately normally distributed. What is the probability that the person will purchase a car that averages less than 20 miles per gallon for in city driving? We have to identify the variables from the problem. The score x is equal to 20 miles, the standard deviation is equal to 3, and the mean 27. Using the formula for the z score, we obtain a score of minus 2.33. Consulting the value table, we get that the probability of getting this score is 0.99%. That probability is too low. I think that person will have to spend more money than he wanted in fuel. Fortunately, he or she is getting realistic. Using the same information, what is the probability that the person will purchase a car that averages between 25 and 29 miles per gallon? Now we have two different X scores. Using the formula and substituting for these two X values, we obtain that when the X score is equal to 25, Z score is minus 0.67, and when X score is 29, the Z score is 0.67. Using the tables, the first probability is 28.43% and the second is equal to 74.86%. Finally, we have to calculate the difference between these probabilities and get that the probability of the car to average between 25 and 29 miles per gallon is 46.43%.
We hope you like this video. Press subscribe, thumbs up, and stay geekly.